Hi, I'm Sam from JigSpace. I'm going to give you an update on a range of improvements we've made to the JigSpace app over the last few months. We've made particular effort to improve the first-time user experience for people who haven't used JigSpace in a long time or are recent new customers. Let's go through some of the updates. The first thing you'll notice in the JigSpace app is that you can create a jig from anywhere in the app via the new jig button. So whether you're in your team area, managing your account, or just exploring the jigs that are available to get inspiration from, whenever you're ready to get started, tap on the new jig button. By clicking this, you'll be given a choice of whether to upload your own CAD files or to use one of the samples in the library. I'm going to do that this time. You'll see now in the library that there are a range of sample CAD files that you can use to either follow along with some of our tutorials or just to play around with the app. We've also added a range of new free objects into the library. There's new effects like radars and flows to bring your CAD files to life, pointers as well. We've refreshed our basic shapes. We've added some new tools which are really useful for creating 3D instructions. And we've uploaded a full library of ISO warning labels, which a lot of our manufacturing customers have been requesting. Each of these things should speed up and enhance your 3D presentations in JigSpace. Let's now look at another update that we've made, which is to make it easier to add an object to a presentation and send it to all of your steps or some specific steps, which has been challenging for users in the past. I'm going to add in a flow effect. And in this case, I'm going to add it to all of my steps. Now, in the past, this was hard for users to figure out how to do this. So what we've done is give you a easy-to-use pop-up that prompts you to determine if you want this added to all of your steps, just this step, or some more specific steps. Now I'm going to say add to all steps. And now each of these steps has the same flow. I'm just going to now format this so you can see me how this might fit into my presentation. There we go. And I'll just make sure that each of these attributes are copied to all of my steps. So now you can see when I navigate to each of these steps, that object that I imported is now on all of them, not just one. You can also still import to a single area. So if I wanted to add in, say, an arrow, for example, I can just say just on this step, only on this step, like this, for example. So it's easy to determine each time you bring in a 3D model to your presentation where you want it to go and if you want it added to all your different steps. You'll notice as I was navigating around the steps that the timeline up here is now updated as well. So if I wanted to rearrange these now, I just have to tap on the pencil icon, click on the thumbnail that I want to change. So I'm going to rearrange that one there, or I could delete and add new steps as well. We hope that makes it a lot easier for desktop users with the mouse to use instead of long clicking. Another improvement that's been long requested by users is tooltips. All you have to do to understand what each button does is hover on it. So if I hover on this icon here, you'll see it says object mode. And I get any keyboard shortcuts that exist as well. So like move for W, rotate, scale, for example. Each of these now have tooltips to tell users what each of these things are. We've made sure as well that for first-time users, there's a handy little tour when they first log into the app. You can always access it here from the help icon. And it will take you through each of the main functionalities of JigSpace. So you can understand how to move around, how to change the camera angles, how to scroll, and how to pan. Covering off how to import your files, adding colors, textures, materials, adding or editing steps in the new user interface. And of course, when you're ready, all the different ways that you can share a jig, whether it's via a QR code, embedding in a website, or just by sharing a link. You'll find each of these items have a link to the relevant area of our help center as well, which has been revamped. Another important improvement we've made for creators is giving you the ability to preview your content in augmented reality when you're on a desktop device. Traditionally, you've only been able to view your jigs in this 3D mode, like you can see on my screen now. Now, when you go to view your jig, you'll be given the option to view in AR. I'll have to first save my jig. And that will then give me a QR code that I can scan with my iPhone or Android phone or an iPad to preview, like this, which will link up with an app clip and immediately load on my device. Doesn't require downloading any apps. It'll work on most devices. You can also click open in browser to get a preview of what it looks like in a web browser. Click on it and it'll take you to our web browser version of the jig, which you can immediately use to grab its URL or to share it. So this is it inside a Chrome browser. Looks pretty cool. Finally, we've made it easier to evaluate JigSpace by removing our 20 megabyte file upload limit and only enforcing our 200 megabyte team storage limit. That should give you enough storage to make a couple great jigs, as well as upload much larger CAD files in the process. When you're ready to find out more about what's on a paid plan, just click the upgrade button to see all of our features or to start a free trial. I can't thank you enough for all of the great ideas, feedback, and emails that we've received over the last few months. If you have any more ideas after watching this or using JigSpace, please get in touch with us. We love to hear your ideas and feedback, and they're quite likely to get incorporated into our future roadmap. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your next jig. Thanks.